by an Indian conglomerate and sells there for about $3,500. The company plans to add a few frills and sell it here in about 3 years for less than 10 grand. And nutrition advocates are now zeroing in on Flamin' Hot Cheetos. The snack food is popular with the kids, but has high levels of salt, fat, and artificial coloring. Nutritionists say Flamin' Hot Cheetos are addictive. Some schools have actually banned it. That's America's Money. I'm Rob Nelson.
There are a lot of warning lights and sounds vying for your attention. So we invented a warning you can feel. Introducing the all-new Cadillac XTS, available with the patented safety alert seat. When there's danger you might not see, you're warned by a pulse in the seat. It's technology you won't find in a Mercedes E-Class. The all-new Cadillac XTS has arrived, and it's bringing the future forward.
When you want to give your immune system some support, try Airborne. With 14 vitamins, minerals, and herbs, like zinc, echinacea, ginger, and a blast of vitamin C. Airborne, real immune support in effervescent and chewables.
Cholesterol-lowering statin drugs can reduce your natural CoQ10 levels, but your heart needs CoQ10. Take Cunol CoQ10. It dissolves completely and absorbs 3 times better than regular CoQ10. Get the better CoQ10. Get Cunol, the gold standard in CoQ10.
The news continues right now on News Channel 5, on your side.
And that is a live look. Let's see, where are we? Thank you, the queue, thank you. My eyes are going. That's the cab sign right there. Now I see it in the dark there. You know, downtown Cleveland is starting to come alive already at 529, seeing a few cars and a lot of lights in that area. Good morning, Cleveland, Pepper Pike, Ravenna, Richmond, Brady Lake, Boston Heights, everybody right here in Northeast Ohio, and thanks for joining us. I'm Macy Jepson.
And good morning, everybody. I'm Mike Dunstan. It looks dry out there. So let's get a check of your weather with meteorologist Jason Nicholas, who's in for Christine. So, Jason, yesterday, not a whole lot of sun. Are we going to see it today?
Yeah, looking better today, guys. We have some clouds around this morning, but as you head through the afternoon, I think you're going to be okay. The shades will need to be brought out. Take a look right now at the Power 5 Live Doppler Network radar. We're moving the clouds out here this morning. It'll be slow, though, so west to east is how we'll dry things out. I should say clear things out this morning. We're all dry. No need for the umbrella. Shaker Heights, good morning. You're at 48, 47 in Euclid, 50 in Mentor, Solon, Chagrin Falls. Temperatures in the upper 40s to near 50. Cloudy and chilly this morning, but we look at increasing sunshine as we head through noon into the evening hours. Mostly sunny skies with temperatures in the 50s. Keep in mind, our normal high this time of the year, guys, about 62 or 63 degrees. So we're going to be very close to that here today, but we're going to go above that tomorrow as 70s do return for us. A sneak peek the 70s. They won't be around for long. We'll talk about that and, of course, our next chance of wet weather. We've got a couple of hurricanes out there, too. We'll discuss all that coming up in just a few moments. 5:31. There's a check of your weather. Now, here's Macy with a traffic update.
All right, Jason, it's time to get everybody out that door and a look at the morning commute to get you ready for it. Right now, no accidents or delays on major highways in greater Cleveland. 90, 71, 77, 480, as well as 271, all looking pretty good. But road construction, well, that's another thing. In Strongsville, the right two lanes are still closed on the I-80 westbound, the Ohio Turnpike between I-77 and I-71. So watch for possible backups there. We'll keep checking with ODOT and let you know if there are any more problems. But for now, that is a look at traffic. And we are following breaking news now out of Cleveland. As we first told you, a man was found murdered on the east side. News Channel 5, Cedra Mayfield uncovered this story while checking with police overnight. Good morning again, Cedra. What can you tell us about how all of this happened?
Well, Macy, I just hung up with Cleveland police. We now know this began as a fight between two people and that police do not believe any weapons were involved. This all started around 2:45 when police and paramedics were called to the area of Lakeshore Boulevard and East 147th. That's where they found a 42-year-old man who had been choked to death. Police still are not releasing that man's name, but again, they are investigating his death as a homicide. Police have made an arrest in this murder. No word yet on who that person is. Now, I'll keep checking in with detectives for updates, but for now, Macy, let's send it back into you.
All right, thank you so much, Cedra. Well, we're talking presidential debate now. Of course, it comes exactly 3 weeks before Election Day. And this time around, people say they know exactly what they want to hear. News Channel 5's Kristen Byrne talked presidential politics with people overnight. And Kristen, first of all, do they even plan to watch the debate?
Macy, everyone I spoke with this morning told me they do plan to watch the debate tonight, and plus they told me they planned to watch it last time too, and they did, but there are some things they didn't like, and take a listen to what they had to say.
It didn't look very good the last debate. You know, it didn't look like he was hungry. He was fighting to win. Hopefully this one, you know, will be a success for him.
Both could have used a little more prep work. And I want to hear more solutions and statistics and solid answers than vague answers to questions and arguments.
We want to hear from you out there what you want to hear from the candidates tonight during the presidential debate. You can log on to our Facebook page. I have it pulled up here on my smartphone, and we've already got